Meanwhile, Doris's arms hang down limply. I hold my breath for as long as she does. When at last she exhales, I reach across the table, take her schnapps glass, knock back its contents, then stand up and walk around the table. Dixie is growling under the chair. I reach down and Dixie sniffs my hand and then licks it. I lift Doris's face up and give her a little shake. Her eyes are half closed. A thread of saliva hangs from her mouth. I wipe it off with my hand.
"The best china,"
she slurs with a dark, dragging voice. I bend down and slide my arms under her knees and around her back. The white silk of her dress is soft against my hands.
"And my best little brother."
My back protests when I pick her up, despite the fact that she hardly weighs anything. Dixie follows as I carry her mistress over to the sleeping alcove.
"It's itching. It's itching so terribly. Can you scratch me, father?"
Her voice is still unnaturally deep. I start shivering. I lay her on the bed and prop up her head with the down pillow. She's breathing calmly. Dixie jumps up and lies at the foot of the bed. I check my pocket watch. 10 minutes, she said. I've just put the Husqvarna together and checked that it works by cocking it when I hear Dixie's claws against the cork mat. Doris's heels give off an irregular sound as she staggers about in there. It reminds me of the endless nights spent tapping the walls between the cells at Longholmen.